not been the best of weeks for Simon Cowell, really. He's split up from his long-term girlfriend, Terry Seymour, and many of the papers have been saying that he's turned to you, Miss Sunita, during his times of trouble. Is that true? Is he sobbing on your shoulder?
Not sobbing, you know. He's actually didn't even manage to squeeze one tear out.
No, he's too tough. He's hard as nails, yeah. That man.
But it has been a tough week, because he didn't get his NTA award for X Factor.
Yes, yes.
We lost Austin on Saturday night, and then, of course, breaking up with Terry. So, you know, it has been hard.
Yeah, I mean, I think people...
No, you sound so sincere.
People are focused on you sort of being friends with him in the papers and stuff. Because I think they've focused on you being friends with him in the papers and stuff because you've sort of, in the very, very long time you've known him, a small part of that, there was a bit of a romance, wasn't there?
Yeah.
But it's more...
Gosh, we've known each other for 25 years. So, you know, of course I'm going to be there for him now. And, you know, and then, of course, with my problems as well, it's kind of... I know it looks very convenient or coincidence, but, you know, really, thank God that we are able to be on hand for each other, because when you're going through a hard time, you want your mates, don't you?
How does your husband, does he feel about your relationship with Simon? Because you are such close friends, but you have had a relationship. Does it ever cause problems with
you? Well, that's the thing. I mean, you know, Andy also knows Simon really well, and before Andy and I were together, in fact, you know, Simon, it's 25 years, so it's kind of anyone who's known me for that long, he's always been there.
So, what about all the implication, you know, in the papers? Does it worry you a little bit? Because they use words, you know, if they want to imply something sinister is going on, they use words like console and comfort and you know, people will be reading that because people do believe what they read in the papers, unfortunately.
Yeah, and the papers aren't implicitly implying anything.
No, they're not implying anything specific, but the pictures and all the headlines... Yes, it is making everybody think, oh, Simon's back with Sunita.
I've actually read it and thought, back off, Sunita,
I know,
he's mine.
She's very upset. Yeah, exactly. It got me into a lot of trouble with Colleen because I promised I was going to help fix you guys up.
Well,
he is available now.
He is, and no doubt been asking about
it. I just think, you know, Simon and I will carry on as normal, like we've always done. You know, it'll be another 25 years, and you know.
Well, I think men can be, you know, well, they're great for you to go and sort of sob on their shoulder. One of my best friends, Michael, in the States, you know, has been brilliant to me in my times of woe, and I've certainly had some capers with him and his little romantic adventures. I remember one of his boyfriends he thought was cheating on him, and he was absolutely outraged. I don't know why, because he was not hardly the faithful type himself. But he made me follow this boyfriend and stand on a car roof and peek over a wall and see what I could see. And
proper capers
together. But you know, we're really great mates, and I think it doesn't really matter what gender they are. If you've got, you know, a best friend that you can sort of turn to in your times of troubles.
Men are harder to console only because sometimes they don't want to talk about stuff.
That macho thing.
Yeah, you can't make someone feel better if you don't really know what's going on or what the problem is. So I suppose they are hard to console. But I mean, if I've got anything wrong, I do go to my best friends. Just happen to be a couple of blokes, you know. And I do talk to them about
everything.
They want
to know what's happening, but they don't want to know what you were wearing at the time, what you were eating, which is what we do.
No.
We get into all the details. Yes. Okay. And what did you have on? And and then what happened? And what did he say next? And so and so there. They just want to know what's going on. How can they help you?
And they're genuinely interested. You know, I've got quite a few friends who if I do have a problem, I do want to talk about it, who would, you know, let me talk for a few minutes, and then they'd start talking about themselves. And I just think, well, you're not really interested in my problem. So, you know, and that's why I don't talk to quite a lot of people. But, you know, if you know you've got real friends, but they do just happen to be a couple of boys. Mm. So,
Paul?
I think...
You'll talk to anyone, really.
I tell the man in the street what's
happened
to me. You never guess what happened to me today. But I, you know, obviously, I think Sunita's right. If I'm talking to my girlfriends, it's every little detail, and you sit there for hours and you laugh and you cry and they want to know everything.
What was his tone?
Yeah,
how did he say it?
But when you're talking to when you talk to a man, there are a lot more. Okay, well, you need to do this and you need to do that.
They want to solve problems.
And if they've got a problem, they just go, oh, it'll be all right, I'll sort it out. They don't want to open up. But you know, and also when me and Ray are listening to somebody's problems, it's amazing to hear a man's advice to a girl and a woman's advice to a girl.
Right.
Because his advice is always so different to my advice, and then we end up having a row. And then we turn to her for advice. And can't get out.
Right, time for a second try at today's competition, where you have the chance to win a whopping 10 grand to spend at Marks & Spencer. What a boost to the winter blues that would be. Here's all the details you need to be in with a chance at winning.
In fashion, drain pipes, flares, and boot cut are all types of what? Is it A, jeans, B, jackets, or C, jumpers? Call 09012 931 941. Calls cost £1 from BT Landlines. Calls from other networks may be higher, and for mobiles will be considerably more. Text A, B, or C to 63303. Text costs £1 plus one standard network rate message. Digital satellite viewers can enter by pressing their red button now, and you can also enter for free at ITV.com. Entrance must be 18 or over. All lines close at 10 a.m. on Saturday, the 8th of November. Entries made after this time won't be counted, but may still be charged.
Very best of luck. Now, it's often a dreaded phase in a woman's life, but scientists have now developed a test that may help women prepare for the menopause. No. Now listen, listen. This breakthrough test measures hormones in the blood to calculate how many eggs are left in your ovaries. Any changes in hormone levels would help to more accurately predict when exactly a woman will enter the menopause. So would you be interested in taking the test? Would it be helpful information for you to know exactly when it's going to kick in?
Absolutely. I'd love it, mate.
Would you?
Yeah, absolutely. But, you know,
why
just...
do you want to know?
Well, because I don't know if we can say that word on television, you know, the monthly thing.
The ladies thing.
The ladies thing. But I'll be celebrating when that's over, let me tell you. I'll be having a menopausal party for Britain.
Will you? A launch party.
Oh, yes. And from a married couple's point of view, and you've had your kids, you can go, well, hey, no need to worry now, love.
Yeah. Let's get a little mist of sunshine, looking on the positive
absolutely.
Side of it.
Absolutely. But so I haven't got any worries about it. And I also think as well, for women that have, you know, or are thinking about, I don't want children yet, mm-hmm. you know, I want to have my career and maybe start when I'm 35 or 36 thinking about having a baby, if they can do the test and they go, well, by 35 or 36 your chances are almost minimal, then they might make a different decision.
I see what you're saying about that, but here's my thing is, if somebody had said to me, oh, well, you know, it's not looking good, I would sort of have kids by the time you're 30, I would have ended up having children with the wrong person. Do you know what I mean? Would it pressure me into having children in a certain time period, not necessarily in the ideal environment? I don't know if it is a good thing to find out that stuff.
I don't know. I mean, that depends on your mental state. It depends how desperately you absolutely want them. I mean, there's women that get to 35 and haven't got a partner and desperately want children and still go out and have them. I mean, nowadays, you know, it doesn't mean you've got to be with,
a partner.
It's accepted that you can be without anybody, be a single parent.
I think it's worrying because, it might create false hope, right? So you have this test and it says, oh, you're going to have the menopause at 44 or something. So you think, oh, well, I've got till I'm about 40. You know, then when it doesn't happen, you've only got a few years left. And then, you know, I just think, I don't understand why people have to have that much control over something which is so natural. You know, having kids, it's an absolute miracle and it's a gift. And if it happens, it happens. Why has everyone got to plan everything? Oh, well, I might have a baby when I'm 38. Right, I'll do my job until this time. Blah, blah, blah. What happened to chance?
Nowadays.
But why can't people leave things to chance anymore? Like, Mother Nature is in charge and always will be, however many tests you take.
If you got married and you said, OK, baby, let's have the first 5 years just enjoying our marriage and then we'll start trying to plan for a family. And then, oops, 5 years down the line, it's too late. Now, maybe
well,
with that
information. Yeah,
but with that information.
Life's tough!
Yeah, but it's not too late. But nowadays, it's not too late, because if you know that you have a limited amount of years, you can get your eggs
harvested.
Why
don't you base your decision on that? If you're going to have babies anyway, just have a baby.
No, but you have to be ready.
If you're not in a financial place to have children straight away, what if it might take you a while to get your first home together and you're trying to do it the right way, and you're trying to be sensible and plan and all that sort of thing?
But there's no guarantees, right? You have the test. Oh, well, I've got ages yet. Leave it another 5 years. It might still not happen.
But if you have your eggs frozen, it can still happen.
Yeah, everything can happen. But why keep doing that? Why do people keep interfering and messing around
because they don't really need to? Every single day of our lives, we mess with Mother Nature. Contraception messes with Mother Nature.
Absolutely.
That's like saying we shouldn't take contraception because it's messing with Mother Nature. We shouldn't take the pill. We shouldn't go on the course. But we do.
Yeah.
We all plan it. We don't want a baby yet, so we have contraception. if we're actually going to go down, let's Mother Nature take its course, then we shouldn't do any of it, anything.
Yeah, but prevention is not the same as creation at all. You know, having a baby isn't, as a lot of people know, isn't that easy. It doesn't happen that easy all that quickly. You know, people just say one day, oh, right, I'm going to have babies, I'm going to have two kids, and then it just doesn't happen. You, Jackie, for instance, were told that you probably couldn't have them, and then, whoops, one day, you're pregnant.
Whoops!
Well, exactly, that's how it happened.
But this is it.
It was meant to be.
Right, but had I desperately want children until I met David. So had we not been able to, we may have explored fertility options. We may have explored, you know, IVF, and how could modern science help us, you know, do that. I mean, I do very firmly believe that there is something man-made that is making fertility a bigger issue these days. There is a rise in breast cancer these days. So whether we're eating it, breathing it, drinking it, something is affecting women's reproductive health, and men's as well.
Why not use
modern science and technology
to correct it, to redress the balance
in some